Hi there. In this tutorial, I'm going to talk about a few different ways that you can get an effect something like this. So this is what's typically called the God rays effect. So we've got a bright light source, and you can see, in this case, coloured light being fanned out and projecting onto the ground. I'm going to compare both Cycles and Eevee. Eevee obviously has its limitations, and show you several different ways that you can emulate this effect. So to begin with, I'm just going to start with my pre-made model. I've just got a very basic sort of church type model here with some pillars in it and whatnot, but essentially it's an enclosed box. I've got a window up here, and I've actually made that by basically creating a pattern on a disc and then duplicating that disc and then turning it into wireframe to give me the black lines. I'm then using a lamp here to shine light onto it. You can see it's there. This is a spot lamp. I know it's called sun up there because I started out trying out a sun lamp, but this is a spot lamp, and I've got a fairly soft shadow on it as well. But the idea is that it's very bright. You can see this is 10,000 watts or 10 kilowatts. That's quite a bright light. So if we look inside, you can see the light is shining through. This is currently in EV mode, so you can see there's a bright light shining through here, and it's shining down onto the floor. Now, one of the things about the EV version of this scene is that there's no color transmitted into the projected image on the ground here. You'll see when we go to Cycles that you do get a colored projection, but I wanted to cover both Cycles and EV render engines, so you'll see a number of differences. So that's our basic scene. What we now need to do is create our God rays. So the classic way to do it is to add mist into the scene. That's how you would see them in real life anyway. So we'll come out to here and we'll just add a cube. I'll scale it up so we can see it. And it really just needs to enclose the building, or at least the parts of the building that we can see, like that. So I'll come back in here, and then we need to put a material on the cube, which is going to be our mist effect. So I've opened a new window up here, and we'll go to the shader editor. I'll call the cube mist, and we'll add a new material. I don't need the principal shader, so I'm now going to add, under shaders, the principal volume shader. Very important that we connect that into the volume input on the material output, not the surface, and you can see it's all gone black. So I'll go to rendered view. You can just about make something out there, but not very much. In order to have the best contrast in our mist or fog, I'm going to change the color of it to white. That's not essential, but it will help to enhance the effect because that's what we're working on here. The next thing I changed was the density. So it's very, very high at the moment, so very little light is coming through. So I set it to about 0.1, and you can see immediately we've got some God rays. There's some other tweaks we need to do for EV, but essentially it's already working. I also played with anisotropy because I found that could increase the contrast as well. So I went for about 0.8. This affects how bright the light is from a given direction, and we can play around with that a little bit, but it does bounce light around. Now at the moment we're producing quite a low resolution volumetric effect. This color banding here is just an artifact of the preview mode. So if we now go to our output settings, as it happens I had ambient occlusion on, but that's probably not going to make very much of a difference to the scene. You could turn bloom on if you wanted a sort of glow effect around here, but the scene I rendered didn't have that. Something worth turning on is screen space reflections, as it will help with light bouncing and things like that. And I turned off half res trace, which just is essentially gives you a faster render, but at the expense of quality. The main thing we want to play with though is volumetrics and shadows. So for volumetrics, as long as your clipping start and end encloses the scene, that's fine, but you want to increase this number. Probably best to do it a step at a time, but I know this scene should be fine with my setup. So I'm going to go straight to 2 pixels. So basically this is a higher resolution of volumetrics, and you can see immediately we've got a nicer and a finer God ray effect here now. I also put the samples up to 256. Be careful because you can easily crash Blender doing that. It just gives you a higher quality render again. You can even play with distribution, but again, be careful with it. I left it at default. And turn on volumetric shadows as well, because that can also enhance it, although I didn't change the number of samples. Under shadows, I did increase this. I'm not sure it made much of a difference, but I went up to 1024 for cube size and 2048 for cascade size. I think it possibly just slightly improves the fidelity of the projected image down here. I also turned on soft shadows. It's up to you whether you use that or not. Obviously you can see the shadow has literally become very soft there. If you want that really clear image, then you can probably turn those off. So there's our first attempt, and that's okay. One of the problems obviously is there's no colour in the light that's shining through the stained glass window, and no colour in the light projected down here. But we'll give that a render and see what it looks like. So there it is. Given this is Eevee, that did take a little bit of time to render. It took 31 seconds. It's by no means perfect. It's very much the sort of effect you would get in a game, and that's the nature of Eevee at the moment. But if you didn't have, for example, a coloured light or a stained glass effect like this, I think this would be a perfectly acceptable God Ray effect. And you can turn down the quality of it to get a faster render. So next, let's go over to Cycles and see what it's like in there. We'll go to slot 1, that was put in slot 2. So we're going to change this over now to Cycles. It'll take a moment or two to recompile. So this is exactly the same scene with exactly the same settings as far as the settings that are shared are concerned. And here is the Cycles preview. Obviously a noisier scene, but we can now see there is colour in our God rays, and you can see colour in the image down here. So there's a couple of things we can do to improve this image from a cycle standpoint. Under light paths, unless you really need them, turn off reflective and refractive caustics. They're the little bright spots caused by light reflecting off curved shiny surfaces or through curved clear objects like glass. It just reduces the level of noise slightly. Next, I'm going to increase the number of volumetric bounces. So you can just experiment to see how many you need to get a decent scene. Now we're getting more light in the scene, but of course we're getting more noise as well because the light is bouncing around in the volumetrics. I went for 3, I think, but we'll just try 2, see how that looks. So at the moment, way too noisy, but we're going to have a look at that in a moment. So that looks unacceptable right now, bearing in mind this is a relatively low number of samples. This is only 32 samples. I'm going to set the render to 64 samples. And we'll set this down to 16 just to speed it up. I've got adaptive sampling on. And then I'm going to come over to here and I'm just going to turn on denoising data because we're going to use that in a minute. We'll go to the preview scene and then I will render that image. So there's our noisy scene. Remember, this is only 64 samples at the moment. And we'll go to the compositor and we'll say use nodes. So obviously the first thing to do is try to make that a cleaner scene. So I'm going to add a filter, which is the denoise filter. I'm going to put that there. I'm going to take noisy image, put that into there, denoising normal into there, and denoising albedo into there, and then take that output into the image output. The denoise takes a moment or two to run, and you can see that's a lot better. It's not perfect, but that's a lot better. We really need to run rather more samples than this, and I also will turn the background down to completely black, which will help. So we'll give that now another render. But we'll put a few more samples in this time and we'll go for 128 and we'll go for 3 light bounces for the volumetrics. I'm also just going to go under performance and just change this to the tile size, which I know tends to work more quickly for my graphics card. So there we go, that's a much more acceptable effect. One word of warning about using denoising and volumetrics, it's generally acceptable on a still image. Doesn't work so well for animations because of the artifacts it creates in areas like this. But overall, I think that's quite an acceptable looking scene. It's quite atmospheric. We've got colours in the God rays themselves and obviously the colour projection down here. But there is one more way that we can do God rays. It will work in either Cycles or Eevee. I prefer Cycles purely because we get the coloured projection down here. But before I can do it, I need to render this scene without the volumetric. So I'm just going to click up here, turn on the little camera icon there, and then I can stop the volumetrics from being rendered. And now I'm just going to re-render the entire scene just without the volumetrics. So I'm just going to render the entire scene without the volumetrics now. So there it is. Much cleaner scene, as you can see, but no God rays. I'm now just going to mute the denoise node because it slows things down a little bit, and I just want to show you what happens with the new node that I'm going to add. So I'm just muting that and you can see we've got a slightly noisier scene, but it's actually not that noisy anyway. So I'm now going to add a new filter called sunbeams. I'm going to add another node and that's going to be a color mix node, and I'll drop that in there. I'm going to set it to add. And I'm going to put the sunbeams node into the other side. And I'm just going to take another version of the output from this node here, the denoise node, which is just acting as a connector at the moment, into the sunbeams node. No obvious change to the scene at the moment. Now, because I've re-rendered this scene previously, I know what I need to do with these numbers. These two numbers are X and Y locations on the rendered image for the bright spot in your scene from where you want sunbeams or God rays to emit. So if I happen to know roughly where I need this to be, and I'm going to set it there and then I'll move it around so you can see exactly what it does. So I'm going to set this one to 0.71 for this particular scene, and this one to 0.935. At the moment, no difference because ray length is at zero. So if I put this at 0.5, it'll take a moment to process, and then we've got God rays. And the great thing about these God rays, even though they are, as it were, fake God rays, is they are colored rays and produced very quickly. And this would be colored rays even in Eevee. The only odd thing is that in Eevee, this projection would still be black and white. And we can change the length of them. So if I wanted to put that at 0.7, for example, once it's processed, you can see they reach all the way to the ground now. So just to show you what happens as you change the point of that. So you'll need to basically search the image, guesstimate where it is, and then search around it to use sunbeams. They are a cheat, as it were, but they are also quite effective. And of course, I can change the brightness of these God rays here and tone them down a little bit because I'm using this mix node. So if I went to lower this number, so this is the Y, so this is the vertical axis on an image, you'll see the God rays all move around. So that's why it's important to know where you want it. I push them back up again and now they're like that. If I change this one, pull that one down a little bit, that's the X. So that's pulled it this way and you can see it's shot off over that way. So you can basically, you're specifying where the bright spot in your scene is, and then anything to the right of that bright spot will have God rays going off to the right, anything to the left of it, to the left, above it, down, and below it, up. So that's why you need to play around with that and adjust it to get the effect you want. But it is a very quick, low cost, as it were, way of getting the God ray effect that you might want, even though it is a fake effect. So if there was something standing in the way, a candle sconce or something here, it wouldn't be casting a shadow because there's no real volumetrics here. This is just fake volumetrics, but nevertheless quite useful in a scene like this. So I hope you found that interesting. If you did, let me know. I'll provide this scene to my patrons, and if you enjoy these tutorials, please don't forget to click like and subscribe. It helps me out, and I will see you in the next tutorial. Thanks a lot.